Sharks and rays are often referred to as living fossils because of the age that they evolved. They've been on Earth for a really long time, about 450 million years. So to put this into perspective, humans evolved 2 million years ago, and some of the marine mammals and other modern fish about 50 million years ago. So these animals have been on Earth for a really long time. My name is Jamie Hicks and I'm a marine ecologist for the Department for Environment and Water. So sharks and rays are a really diverse, big group of animals. We have over 500 species of sharks all around the world and over 600 species of rays. We are fortunate enough in South Australia to see about 65 species regularly. Some of the more common local South Australian species you might have seen include southern eagle ray, Port Jackson shark, smooth ray, southern fiddler rays and wobbegongs. And the reasons you might have seen these species as they are typically seen more coastally in inshore waters. So they often inhabit shallow bays, estuaries, seagrass beds and reefs. We also get species that are typically more offshore or inhabit deeper marine environments, such as gummy shark, short fin mako, school shark, smooth hammerhead, common thresher shark, seven gill shark. These species are really mobile and migratory and often inhabit more of the oceanic and pelagic marine environments. You may have also seen or heard of the white shark and bronze whalers. These species actually inhabit both inshore and offshore habitats as they are also very migratory species, so they are highly mobile and can utilise more habitats.
One of the interesting things about white sharks and bronze whalers is that we actually share populations of these sharks with different states and potentially different countries. So they're geared up for doing big transoceanic migrations, meaning they're highly migratory.
There's still so much we don't know about particular species, and this is because they are challenging to study. There is so much mystery and elusiveness to them. So we currently use baited remote underwater video systems known as BRUVs to look at different habitats, and we do detect different shark frequencies and species on these cameras. However, due to their highly mobile nature, we often as scientists need coupled methodology to study them. So that can include tagging, genetics, drones and fishery-based capture methods. So this is also what makes it challenging and expensive to study these animals. So identifying sharks and rays can also be really difficult because there firstly are so many species, but also there aren't always visual features where we can look at an animal in the environment and know what it is. So to give you an example, gummy sharks and school sharks are often quite hard to tell apart, and it is just really the positioning of the dorsal fins, and the gummy shark has a larger dorsal whereas the school shark has a smaller dorsal.
Some of the species you might not have seen is because they are found in deeper mesophotic marine habitats. These are whiskery sharks, saw sharks and spur dog sharks. We have only recently been able to view these species as we utilise baited remote underwater video systems deployed to deeper marine environments where humans cannot go. It's important that we learn about these species too and the threats that they might face.
Because sharks and rays have slow growing, long lived and conservative life history, this makes them more vulnerable to different pressures, including overfishing, shark finning, habitat, prey loss. So this makes them particularly vulnerable, and a lot of the different species we have threatened conservation status. As a girl, the first time I experienced seeing a shark in the water, I just thought it was so graceful and so beautiful, and realised how misrepresented these animals are. And they're not just man-eating predators, they're highly complex, diverse species. So I also think that's really important to collect knowledge on these species and share it with people so they understand and value their importance in the ecosystems.